Shall we start?
Hey, don't worry. We've got plenty of time. So, how did you find the body?
Hello. We're on our way to the city when we passed by the House of the Rights. We figured out to stop by first and ask Mr. Wright if he could buy supply to us.
Wait, when exactly was this?
It was yesterday morning. So I knocked. But the door was left open. I assumed it wasn't an invitation to enter. So I entered and called out for Mr. Wright. No one really answered. And so I walked in and saw Mr. Wright looking very terrible. Hey, Miss Rice. I didn't mean to just come in. The door was left open and I...
Oh, it's fine, dear.
So, can I talk to Mr. Wright?
Sure you can. But I bet if you can find him...
What? Is he not home? Is he not here? I just wanted to talk about the supplies I wanted to sell him.
He's home! But you won't find him.
What do you mean?
He's upstairs. Dead.
So I called for Harry and he went upstairs.
And what did you see?
I saw Mr. Wright's body. A rope tied in his neck.
And that's when you called the police?
No, not yet. We don't know what to do at that time. We went downstairs and we talked to Mr. Wright.
He's dead! He's dead!
Mrs. Wright, are you alright? What happened to Mr. Wright?
Wright! My husband is dead.
What? How did it happen?
I have no idea. No idea. I was sleeping, really asleep. Then I might not heard someone entered our room and killed my husband. Then I just woke up this morning and saw him. Who wants some tea?
She's acting so strange. I really don't get what she's saying. That was the time Harry called the police. And Miss Wright stayed where she's sitting.
Do you have any reason or anyone you know who could have done this to Mr. Wright?
No, I don't have any. It's the first time I've been with the Wrights. But I don't have any suspect at all. But Miss Wrights? I don't think she can do that to her husband.
Hell, this is a lot harder than I thought. Well, I appreciate your time, Mr. Wright. It will surely help the case.
No problem.
Have a nice day, Mr. Wright.
You too, sir.
We'll just inform you about the progress of this case. That the court may call you once in a while for further investigation. Okay, see you around, Mr. Wright.
Henry? Henry! How did it go?
I guess it's fine. The case will surely need some time.
I know.
What are you doing?
We're in the kitchen, just checking out some things. Have you been there? There might be something that could help you guys with the case.
Yeah, at the kitchen? I don't think so.
Oh yeah, the suspect must preserve something in a jar and put it in the refrigerator like a jam.
We could never be sure. Just follow me.
Hey, Mrs. Hill. Your husband just left. We didn't know that they're here.
Oh, I know. And it's alright.
Now, let's see what's in here. It's just a bunch of mess. Banana peels.
Dirty kitchen tools and towels. Unwashed dishes.
Oh, in the birdcage. What happened with Mrs. Wright's ability to clean up the mess? No wonder this house gave a power of banana.
Hey, don't judge. There's a lot of things to be done with the farm.
She must have been exhausted.
Look, she did not even finish her trifles.
Why do women worry so much about trifles? There's nothing in here.
Yeah, come on now. They might need more hands upstairs. I heard they're taking the body. Let's take one last look.
Mrs. Peters, have you seen this poor little bird?
Whoever did this must be out of its mind. Look at its neck. Do you think? Oh, no,
There must be a reason behind this bird's death. The same reason as John's death? Do you think Minnie Foster Wright killed her husband?
Shush! Bite your tongue, Mrs. Peters. Mrs. Wright is a very cheerful person. She loves to sing, dance, music is her life.
But Mr. Wright is so strict. He never liked noise in his house. He did not like the chirping bird as well as Mrs. Wright's music. She killed him the same way he killed this bird.
Mr. Wright is very strict and uptight with everything. Pitiful Mrs. Wright. We're going to keep this as a secret, as well as this little bird.
We live in the same county, far from each other. Yet, we experience the same things.
Ladies.
Okay.
They took the body. Attorney was out talking with Franco. He's holding me in his case.
What?
But Attorney Henderson hardly believes in everything that the police tried to say.
Yeah, but she's unbelievable. So, what are you up to now, ladies?
Well, we're planning to bring things to Mrs. Wright. She might need this to have some time in jail.
I think that won't be necessary. The police are taking her back here. At least for a while.
Well, that's a good news.
Hey, what happened to the bird? It was just there, right?
Oh, so what? It's dead.
Whatever. Hey, Anderson. The deputy wants to talk to you.
What?
I don't know what it's up to, but after that, you have to go with me uptown. You have to submit the case at the court while I sign some papers.
Well, you better go. Hey, don't wait up. I'll be home late.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you, officer. You're welcome.
Hey, welcome home.
Who are you? And don't touch me!
Oh hey, it's alright. We are your neighbors. Listen, Minnie. Do you have something to do with this?
Oh! No! No, that's my bird. I saw him kill it. It was him. He killed it.
What are you talking about?
Just leave me alone, please. Just leave.
We just want to help you.
No, I don't need any help. It's too late. It's not the same as before. I'm not happy anymore. I killed him. I didn't mean to. I killed him. I killed my husband.
Minnie, listen.
No. He's been so harsh and mean. I did everything, but he's never happy, never satisfied, is he? I love my husband, I really do, but is it because of my cooking skills? Or because I cannot give him a child? I don't know, I really don't know. So I killed him. I didn't mean to, but I did. It was after that night, our big fight, that he killed that bird. And later that night, I did not realize what I was doing until I saw him stop breathing. I killed my husband.
Minnie.
Hang on for a moment.
Do you think I should seek help for my child, those ladies? What do you think?
Miss Wright, it is the police officers. Pump,